Hello, and welcome to Introduction to Python and Jupyter. Basically, today we'll be talking about sort of how to get the Python environment to run within the Jupyter environment specifically. Python being the programming language and Jupyter being the environment it will run in. We'll be using a GitHub repository, Dudas PM, PSU, Python workshop, and this will be provided in the links as well. Basically, what we'll be talking about overall through these conversation is looking into programming, some basic introduction to Jupyter, how to download things from GitHub and actually run it within the Jupyter environment, some of the mechanics of Jupyter, and some basic introduction to Python as well. There's also in that GitHub repository an example project. We won't go through specifically that, but that'll be available in case you want to go through that additional information and where to get help long term as well. Assuming that you're here, that you probably already want to learn about the program, but a lot of programming has to do with like removing some large issues when it comes to human error. Also some better analysis with your data, speeding up tasks that are repeated over and over again, and letting the computer doing a lot of the work for you. And overall, if you're doing this on a researching basis, increasing the idea of reproducibility as well. Why Python and not R? Well, the nice thing about Jupyter, Jupyter actually is a sort of a breakdown of the word Julia, Python, and R. And basically, it sort of runs all these environments natively within the Jupyter environment. So even though you might have an R background specifically, you can still use these in the Jupyter environment as well. You can actually mix and match different languages within these Jupyter notebooks. But for the most part, Python is just one of those programs that is it's free in terms of its open sourceness and sort of free in terms of its capabilities, and it already has lots of documentations and tutorials and libraries already available for it. So let's just start with getting everything up and running. First thing you should do is actually go to the Anaconda webpage. If you do a Google search of Anaconda Python, basically this will be one of your first selections. Anaconda is sort of a larger, different programs and sort of things that are sort of built into it, but it handles a lot of the back end stuff that we need to think about. After you get to the website, you'll click on Downloads. And you should select for whatever environment you're in. So typically we're in Windows, but you know, if you have a Mac or a Linux machine, please make sure that's selected for the appropriate system. Next, we're actually going to utilize the Python 2.7 version. Obviously, it's a little bit older than the 3.7 version, but for the most part, it's one of the more documented and most upkept sort of Python versions at this point. And we'll continue to be sort of looked at through the next couple of years as well. So we'll be using the 2.7 version for this. So click on that and download that. I'm going to assume you're going to go through this process and download this locally to your machine. What you're going to do next, and again, this is running in a Windows environment, but you know, for the most part, should be you know, something that we should see through other programs as well, is you're just going to search for Anaconda and select Anaconda Navigator. Once you click on that, it should open something up like that looks like this. This is the Anaconda Navigator, and as you can see, like I mentioned before, it actually has the ability to run a bunch of different sort of programming environments that you might want it to utilize. But for today, we're going to be using the Jupyter Notebook environment. You're going to click on that launch button, and this should open up in your browser. What you're going to notice initially is the fact that it's going to open up in something called Localhost. Localhost basically means it's local to your machine. So basically, this lets you know that you're working locally on the machine that you're currently on. In here, we're going to have a bunch of different folders, and for today, I'm going to be working in this presentation folder, so select that. From there, this is where you're going to actually be able to put your various notebooks and start working on these types of projects. The first thing we're going to do actually is to create a new notebook inside of this. So I'm going to create new, and then on this list you're going to see a number of different things. This may be a little bit different based on what's installed on your machine, but for the most part, everyone should have Python 2. That's the 2.7 that I mentioned before. Outside of that, you should have a one for text, folder, and terminal. We're going to go into folder, and it's going to create a new folder for us. To rename that, we're going to click on the left checkbox right there and click rename. Name it workshop. One more time. There we go. Workshop. And again, I'm going to go inside that folder. If I just wanted to open up and start actually developing my own notebook, I would only have to click on the new and then Python 2. And that should open up another window for us. and then we can start developing in here. A couple things I'll show real quickly is the fact that, let's say we wanted to just run a simple program, so 2 plus 2. There's a couple ways you can run each of these, and they're called cells. And the idea of Jupyter is basically you create cells and you can run them independently of one another. If you run all, which you go by clicking cell and then run all, it's going to run from top to bottom. So let's do that, run all. And obviously I only have the one cell, so it runs that, gives me the output of 4. I can also click on run cells, or I can actually click on this run button right here, and it'll do the same thing. Another one is in terms of in Windows, you can click on Control and Enter, and that'll just run the current cell that you're in. And if you're interested in trying to figure out what shortcuts are available, under the help, there's one for keyboard shortcuts, and it'll give you a listing of all of those. So basically, at this point, we've started a notebook. We might not want to rename it, so let's say we click up here, and I'll just say test, rename. And now that's saved into my workshop, or in my workshop folder in the Jupyter environment. So that's, if you see the .ipynb, that basically is the Jupyter notebook. So now we have that open, and we now have that available. So what I'm going to do now actually is go to the GitHub repository that I mentioned. GitHub, Dudas PM, PSU, Python Workshop. And in here, basically, we're going to have a couple workshops available. We're going to be specifically looking at Workshop 1, because that's where the material we'll be working at today. But Workshop 2, which we will also have some information as well. But again, focus on the Workshop 1. To get this downloaded, all you have to actually do is go over here to the screen button and click Download, and download zip. This will download it, and I'm going to open it here. And I'm just going to move it to my desktop. Now in my desktop environment, in the desktop, basically you can unzip this by double clicking on it, and then I'm just going to take that the contents of that folder and put it right directly onto the desktop as well. Close out of those windows. Now when we go back into Jupyter, and close out of, or I can keep that open for a minute, and close out of this. And then now within the Jupyter environment, we can do something. Instead of creating a new file, we can upload. So click on upload, go to desktop, and then we'll see that PSU Python Workshop -master. Make sure you're not going into the .zip. Go into Workshop 1 and just select everything and click open. Then you have to manually click through these, but you go click upload, upload, upload. And there you go. Now everything is uploaded and able to be run within this environment. So let's go through and show specifically going into one of these notebooks.